will trickle out of bounds and will remain with the Warriors. Can they get one shot here with 6 seconds left? Here's Malone. Back out for McAdam. McAdam got a fire on Cage. His shot goes! And the Warriors win!
8/10 of a second left on the clock. What a shot.
Brad McAdam wins it, and the celebration is on for the second-ranked Warriors as they come in and knock off the Dolphins 12-11 in our first overtime session. Wow. McAdam with the tally with 8/10 of a second left. The Warriors win, and a stunned silence falls here in Syracuse as Merrimack celebrates the conference championship win.
What a finish, and I want to go back to that, the shot before the game-winning goal, the one that just missed high. It looked like Krupka could have caught that one, but he opted to let it go and went out of bounds, stayed here with the Warriors, and ultimately led to the game-winning goal. But, I mean, what a shot going top shelf. And Merrimack, I think, really earned this victory. They are the better team today, deserve to win, and justice was served in the end.
Justice was served, but a terrific effort by both these teams. Obviously, Lemoyne showing the heart of a champion, scoring 5 late goals to send this game into overtime. But it was Brad McAdam tallying with 8/10 of a second left in our first overtime session. The sophomore from the Neshantuck Station, New Jersey, with the game winner beating Krupko over his upper left shoulder to win it by a final score of 12-11. Kenny, a sensational game, a very entertaining game to watch. And you can see the Warrior players celebrate, the fans that made not a short trip out here to Syracuse from up there in Massachusetts, about a 5-hour ride, rewarded for their trip. Give Merrimack credit. They knocked off Adelphi in fine fashion on Friday, had their way with the Warriors, and then headed out here, got into Syracuse last night, took care of business, and had a short walk through yesterday, and took care of business today, and they win by a final score of 12-11. So congratulations to the Warriors. Also, obviously, congratulations to the Dolphins on a sensational season. Both these teams will continue play. They will both earn berths into the NCAA tournament. I stay corrected. Oh! No automatic bid. I stand corrected. But we're confident. We're confident. But Merrimack wins the conference championship. Obviously, 12-11 is our final score. Teams will line up and shake hands, and a dejected Lemoyne bunch, an ecstatic Merrimack bunch. Kenny, Your thoughts on this one, 12-11, our final score. I thought just a sensational matchup between, obviously, two of the top teams at lacrosse at this level.
Yeah, the two best teams in the North region by far, and it's what a turnaround for Merrimack after the last three times they played here, they'd been blown out. It hadn't even been close. I think the closest game was like an 8-goal margin. But today they played with a purpose throughout. They withstood some early pressure from the Dolphins. They hung in there, relied on their goaltender in the first half, their offense in the second half. They showed some remarkable resiliency by winning in overtime. There's a lot of teams blowing a 5-goal lead late in regulation that would have hung their heads and said it's just not meant to be, especially the way this rivalry had gone over the past few years. But Merrimack hung with it, and then McAdam with 8/10 of a second to go. The shot heard around the world, yeah. North Andover, Massachusetts.
Yeah, North Andover. They will be celebrating and talking about that one for a long time. The sophomore, Brad McAdam, the midfielder, tallies with 8/10 of a second left to give the Warriors the conference championship win. So congratulations to Merrimack. They win by a final score of 12-11. Congratulations, obviously, also to Lemoyne. The top-ranked Dolphins fall to defeat for the first time this year by a final score of 12-11. A sensational performance by both these teams. I thought a very entertaining game to watch throughout, and certainly one that would be a privilege to be a part of here this afternoon.
I couldn't agree more. It's a shame to see it end, a shame that the team had to lose, but that's the way sports is.
We do want to remind you that if you'd like to watch today's game again, please log on to northeast10.tv for access to the free on-demand archive. And we're going to take a break, and then we're going to go down to the field and have some wrap-up. We'll have some statistics, some player interviews, and all that good stuff. So we're going to take a break. We want to invite you to stay tuned for the presentation, the championship, the awards, and all that good stuff. The Merrimack Warriors, the Northeast 10 Conference lacrosse champions for 2010. 12-11, the final score. We'll take a break and wrap it up when we return right here. You're watching Northeast 10 Conference podcast on northeast10.tv. Joined now by Coach Mike Morgan. Celebratory mood, Coach. Final score 12-11. You get the victory in overtime. Walk me through the final 5 minutes. You have a pretty convincing 5-goal lead. You know, against a team like Lemoyne, it's never enough. Talk me through that and then what you said to the kids before they went into overtime.
Well, obviously they're a good team, and we knew that, you know, to get to 12, that was probably the number we're going to have to get to. It was, you know, they went on that run and, you know, good teams go on runs, and it was nice to see the composure we had down the stretch. I would say the last couple minutes came into overtime. We said first time out, first faceoff, we're going to get a timeout. We'll come out after that. Run a couple things. We've been running all day, and we got a couple good shots, and they got the ball back. We got the stop we needed, and, you know, it was just – you know, it's sweet winning, but with 0.8 at Lemoyne, 12-11, I mean, it's a step, like we said, in pregame for the program. And I think, the freshmen will remember it for their 4 years, and then the seniors, they're the ones who got us here. So
I got to ask you about a couple of individual performances. Obviously, Brad McAdams' tally, you talked about with 8-10s, and the play of your netminder, of course, Benali, who I thought was sensational throughout.
Of course. Corey's Corey. I mean, he makes saves when he has to, and the one he had on Harma Tuck down there behind the back, I mean, that kept us in the game when they made that run. And you know, Brad, he made a couple mental errors trying to run the ball out, and I told him we were going to need him to make a play, and he's the guy, he's only a sophomore, but he's a guy who plays with confidence, and, you know, when he had the ball, I knew we were going to get a good shot. I mean, I knew we were going to get something, and did I think, top right with 0.8? Probably not, but, hey, it is what it is. I mean, we've been saying all year that we know we're as good as any team in the country, and today was a good day to come prove it, so.
Coach, congratulations on the win. Before I let you go, obviously, the conference championship, you've talked about increasing the benchmark, increasing the standard. What does this win mean for your program?
That's what it is. I mean, it increases the standard from, when we made it to the Final Four, we said, that's great, but it's not good enough. We won a national championship. But, I rag the guys all the time that I'm the only one that has an NE10 championship. So,
not anymore.
I was going to say, trust me, hey, I would rather them have one than me now. So, in general, I mean, it was just, the guys now understand that as NE10 champs, next year we come back defending, and Lemoyne's going to be Lemoyne again next year. It'll be just as good. So, I mean, we're happy what we did, and, I congratulate, Dan and those guys, and, they'll do well in the Final Four, there's no doubt about that. But, it's our day today, and I think it's good to come out here with a W and just have the guys, understand that the hard work and what we talk about, got us this level, and now we move ahead for next year.
Congratulations on the win, Coach.
All right, thank you.
Appreciate it. 12-11, the final score. What's Coach Mike Morgan? I'm not going to leave him hanging. I apologize. Brad McAdams, who come aboard here and join me, Brad. Congratulations, first of all, on the win. Walk me through the final minute or so.
I just knew there was like 5 seconds left and we needed to get something, so I brought him to the middle and just let it rip. Score 0.8 seconds. I don't remember much. Hit the ground in my head. A little blurry.
Coach Morgan's told me that you made a mistake earlier. He said you were kind of hanging your head a little bit, said, hey, I'm going to need you to make a play later. None bigger than that last goal. The shot, walk me through if you can remember, the upper right, Coach Morgan said, I knew we were going to get something good when I get the ball in the hands of that guy McAdam made a play for us.
Yeah, well, I was hearing 5 seconds left, and I knew he thought I was going to go to my right, so I brought him my left, went back to my right in the middle, and just let it rip. I mean, someone hit me, head hit the ground, blurry.
Never felt as good, though, right?
No, never. This is the best feeling ever.
Brad, congratulations, obviously, the most valuable player award of the conference, this conference tournament. What does this win mean for the program, Merrimack?
It's the biggest win yet so far. I mean, we made it to the Final Four last year, but, I mean, we lost to Lemoyne by a big deficit. I mean, this year it just feels good to beat them. Finally to beat them in 12-11 overtime, that's amazing.
Brad, congratulations today. Great victory. Brad McAdam, the game winner here today in overtime. 12-11, the final score. We'll send it back upstairs to Kenny.
All right, thank you, Jacob VanRyn. I'm going to send this one out now for Jacob VanRyn and the rest of the entire PAC Network crew. This is Kenny Kopp saying so long from Syracuse. Once again, your final score here in overtime, the Merrimack Warriors 12 and the Lemoyne College Dolphins 11.